This conference will now be recorded.
So today we are going to see what is S/4HANA, why S/4HANA, and how S/4HANA useful for you coming down the line. Like now, when you learn basis, when you go for a job, they will ask you, have you worked on S/4HANA? You have to say, yes, I have worked on S/4HANA. So for that reason, you should know what is S/4HANA. Still now, in 1970s, we have R1. Okay, 80s, we have R2. In 90s, we have R3. R3 means real-time architecture. Okay, that's SAP version, R3. Now, they're coming with the S4. Okay, now they're coming with the S4. Instead of R3, now they come up with the S4. S4 and the two HANA. Okay, the challenges with they facing by existing customer overcome all this. See what happened? I discussed you all this previously also. Why they come up with HANA kind of thing? Because they face many challenges with the customers for all the reasons. Data is not able to fetch, system is not getting all data which they require, system gets hung many times when they use third party databases. Third party database means like you can talk on Oracle, you can take DB2, MaxDB, SQL, anything. Those are not the priority of SAP. SAP also taking the databases from third parties. SAP also indulge many times to rectify many things, but they are not. Okay, because it has got many limitations. Now they come up with idea, we need to get our own database to eliminate all these errors. We have to come up with our database. Then they decided to go with a HANA database with eliminate the hard drive features. Because in HANA, you never find hard drive. In HANA, you never find hard drive. Only and only we have RAM. RAM work as a database also, application servers. So, because it's called the in-memory technology. In-memory technology means what? The database which stores in RAM is known as a in-memory technology. But there is no hard drive. So, because the processing time takes more in a hard drive only. So eliminate the role of hard drive totally. So then they have good results out of that. Then they started, they released this in 2011. What? Only and only HANA database to show the world key, we have something to show you. If we can extract data. See, in Oracle, if data extract takes 1 hour, for example, but in HANA, if you find the same query, it takes only 6 minutes, 5 to 6 minutes. Where is 1 hour? Where is 6 minutes? There is a major difference between HANA and the other databases. Now what happened? Now they come up, first they introduced only and only HANA database, then they implement same thing on BW on HANA in 2012. Then coming down the line, they plan to switch everything to the ECC. Then they come up with the thing called S/4HANA. Now you will see how this works. This is a business suite for HANA. The name of software is SAP Business Suite for HANA. Okay, it's a new product and next generation of business applications. This application will run for next generations. The application will for next generation for all the small, big and medium and Fortune 500 companies throughout the globe, throughout the world. Okay, fully built on memory platform. It's called a S/4HANA. Fully built on memory platform. Provide an instant insight by using a single source of truth, real-time processing, dynamic planning, and changes. It means what? It will give actual results at any point of given time. And you can make dashboards, analytics, whatever you want. Okay? On dynamic basis. On dynamic basis. It's a modern, simplified and user experience, and it will be worked on all the devices. Like you can use on tab also, mobiles also, laptops also, desktops also, because now you can use while traveling also. If you want to see any report in urgency, you can just open your tab and see, because it has got integrated with all the devices. Okay, and reduce data prints and your company doing aggregates. Aggregates, when you shift from Oracle to HANA, whenever you have to remove all your old aggregates, but all duplicacy will be get removed when you move on to HANA system. Okay, and you have a choice of deployment. You can deploy on premise also, on cloud also, hybrid also. What is premise? But the system will be at your building, in your premises, servers with you only. On cloud means you take a third party like Amazon or Oracle Cloud or SAP Cloud or Azure Cloud, and you deploy your servers there on a contractual basis. Hybrid means what? Hybrid means you can put some servers on premise and some servers on cloud. That becomes a hybrid. And when you do HANA thing, when you read HANA documents, you will get more on what is premises, what is cloud, and what is hybrid, and how it works for different companies. The full form of S/4HANA is a simple SAP Business Suite for Business. It's a new product. It's completely redesigned to utilize maximum performance of SAP HANA and end user screen vision Fiori, which is a new front end. As till now, what we use SAP GUI and Web GUI for accessing the SAP. But here we have new interface called Fiori. Here we have new interface called Fiori. Fiori we can install anywhere. You can install even on iPhones also. iPhone has got, if you go to their Play Store, they have got one application with Fiori. If you install that, you can install it on any device, Fiori, and you configure the things and start working there. There, but in coming down the line after 4 or 5 years, there will be no GUI. We have to work with Fiori only. Okay, is a new front end. Okay. It is a next-generation product. The screens that are using are more user-friendly, and the reports can be executed faster. They will give a form of bars and charts. So, with the help of S/4HANA, what we can do? You can execute any kind of record. You can execute any kind of record reports, and it's a very user-friendly. And you can manipulate reports whenever required in fraction of seconds only. It's fully built on in-memory platform. SAP HANA, why name S/4HANA is based on SAP HANA database. S/4HANA means what? When you use S/4HANA with the SAP application, only one thing will get changed. Till now, we are using Oracle database, Sybase database, okay? DB2, MaxDB, Oracle. But when you use S/4HANA, you have to use database call only, and only HANA will work on HANA will work with it. Only and only HANA will work with this. Okay, that is the name of the on the basis of that only they give S/4HANA is based on HANA database. Now, what HANA people try to do, they try to implement everything. They try to redesign whole SAP into S/4HANA. First, they started with few modules like FI module, MM module, and now they are trying to build a convert everything like CRM kind of thing, SRM kind of thing, and the PS kind of thing, BPC kind of everything into HANA. After in 2024-25, when you try to purchase SAP, they will give single suits like HANA in which you can able to do all the things you require. If you want BI, BW on HANA, SAP on HANA, ECC on ANA, S4 and everything, each and every module, they try to reshuffle. But first they started with finance and successfully implemented simple finance. And after that, they implement on IMM. They successfully implemented called logistics. Like that, what they're doing in FI for a table, like in FI, if you work FI consultant, FI consultant key, each table, they have got 200 columns. Minimum 150-200 columns, in which 40-50 columns they never used. 40 columns they never use. They use only 10-15 columns from the entire table structure. So what SAP does, they eliminate, they remove all unused columns, and they reshuffle all the tables with new tables. But the values which they require all the time, they will keep all those tables. They merge our table, they merge all the tables into one table. From like previously, if you have 40 T codes or 40 tables which you work on, now when you start working with SAP S4HANA, you need to work with only 12 to 15 tables only, because they merge everything into the new tables. That is the one most good feature. By people are so happy to get all the reports on time and with removing all the aggregates. As we discussed, choice of deployment on-premise, on-cloud. On-premise, you can purchase the hardware like traditional way. On-cloud means, which if you are not afford, which means if you are not affordable the cost of hardware, then you go with a cloud-based solutions where you don't require any hardware. Everything provided by AWS or the cloud provider, then you have to pay monthly maintenance bill. Customers have lots of benefits if they're going with the cloud. The maintenance cost will reduce, the staff cost will reduce. Okay, the tensions of getting upgrades, patch upgrades, system upgrades, all this will be because everything looked after by the cloud people only. And what is S4 hybrids? One entity on premise and other cloud will interface between these two entities. The kind of scenario called a hybrid. Here, what happened? Who use hybrids? Hybrids only used by banks or financial institutes, government institutes, army, all sectors using hybrids because they don't want to get their data leaked by any hacker for any reason. They don't want to get a chance. Like our RBA bank or any other bank, okay, and Indian Army, you can say, they all, those institutions, like the institution, go with IP solution only. They keep production with them only, and the development quality they can put on cloud without any issue, and they make a connection. See, they'll make interface between these two entries. That kind of scenario called a hybrid scenario. Even if it is cloud, you can access whenever you want. You can access it whenever you want, however you want. Like that is on premise only, because with the interface we can connect both entries. SAP HANA Evolution. SAP HANA is a great simplified enterprise software. SAP HANA is in-memory platform introduced in 2011. Okay, And in 2000, after introducing of HANA database, what they have done, they implement it on BW to fetching and developing it reports. That business warehouse powered by S4HANA, the real-time analytics related in 2012. First, they implement the HANA database on BW, which the name was SAP Business Warehouse powered by, you have to remember this name, sir. 2012, they implement S4HANA database with the database. Then they implement same thing on SAP Business Warehouse powered by HANA. This is purely only for real-time analytics and real-time reporting, only for reporting purpose. Means in Oracle, if you take any other reports to run, okay, which takes 6-7 hours to run, but in HANA, it's complete, it will get complete in 1 hour, less than 1 hour. By that only, they show entire world key. Now they have the HAB database, which can suffice all their requirements. And after that, the business suite powered by HANA. Business suite powered by HANA, now they have got two solutions. I think we discussed OLEP and OLTP. Previously, what happened traditional way, we have to purchase different OLEP systems and we have to purchase different OLTP systems. But when you talk about S4HANA or HANA database, the OLTP and OLEP works together parallelly. HANA has the things which can change as OLTP and OLEP according to the requirement. Okay, OLTP means to enter data, OLEP means to extract data. It's the hardware designed in such a manner. You can use it as OLEP also and OLTP also. Okay. Otherwise, in traditional way, we need to purchase EC servers as OLTP and reporting servers as a OLAP in traditional way. But now things have changed. Now, Simple Finance powered by HANA. Have you heard about this Simple Finance? Simple Finance means it's a FI. It's a FI kind of thing. Instance. Financial insight, no aggregates, single, they introduced this on 2014. Not only this, they introduced logistics also. They introduced logistics also. Now they try to put all functional models into S4 SAP, S4. Okay. In SAP S4 HANA, simplified data models, user experience, advanced processing, and we have choice of deployments like cloud, Ibis, Docker, and it has got advanced processing. And we have a new user experience means we can use Fiori instead of your SAP GUI when you install S4HANA on your systems. Now you see the journey of S4HANA. In 2008 and 2009, maybe earlier to that, they thought, how can we improve our process speed? How can we increase our reporting speed? They got answer from the current DB. Answer from current DB, which they used. SAP won't have their own database before 2011. As we discussed earlier, because many escalations are there from the clients. Because clients are paying cross-off requests each year as a maintenance. Then they ask SAP, we are paying this much amount to you. Why are not giving solutions to us? Because see, if you have 1 million record, you can access 2 million. If you have 1 trillion of records in a table, because see, I work with the clients who having 28 terabytes of data, 26 terabytes of data. And if you see each table consists of 300 to 400 GB of space. Like not all tables, some tables, like some financial tables who enters data from 1999, 1998 in that table. The table goes so huge, if you run any query, it will come out without extending the record, because whenever you fresh any query, it has to read all the records sequentially, make a index and giving output. So it is not possible with the current scenarios, so it gets failed. That is the reason why what SAP decided, they don't have their own database before 2011. Okay, it always used third party database, like all these data, these all are database names. Okay, they realized that the traditional data which used was getting a late to access data. Now they decided to design a own DB. ONDB in 2011. Okay, they announced that their whole database S/4HANA in 2012, they come up with the first application of SAP Business Warehouse powered by HANA. It was a BW, which was redesigned by SAP. The previously BW used it with ECC. Now BW used it with SAP HANA. For that, they have taken so much of pain to redesign the whole BW part, because existing is work with only ECC systems. Now they have to use this for, not for this ECC, but for HANA. They have to redesign the whole module. They designed and tested, it went successfully. And after success of BW, they come up with the SAP Business Suite powered by SAP HANA in 2013, which is EHP7 on HANADB. The server which are using, both of you, is a EHP7 system, but we are using SQL on top of that. But you can use HANA also, because previously we see all our applications components are 601, 602 till 606. But when they jump to HANA EHP7, they owned, instead of going to 607, they directly went to 617, because they did a huge enhancements, huge changes in database structure, OS structure, and the utilization of memory and RAM. That is why they give a new code to that as EHP7, and the component is 61. The base series will be a, instead of 607, they made it as 617. They redesigned the whole SAP. So you have to remember few names, okay? SAP standard, Simple Finance in 2014, powered by SAP S/4HANA. They started once with finance process simplification. They made it a, the name is as a Simple Finance, okay? And 2015, they come up with a simple version of S4, Simple Finance, Simple Logistics, and the core modules like SDMM, PPFI, the first version released on 2015. Which version? This S/4HANA, Simple Finance version, they released S/4HANA. What they have done? They reduce all the table columns, and they take only tables and columns which required, which is used on regular basis. They redesign the all modules as per S/4 specifications. Now you see what is S/4 Enterprise Management, SAP S/4 Enterprise Management. What is SAP S/4 Enterprise Management? S/4 is a core which consists of different applications. S/4 sits in between, okay? It sits in the middle. If you heard about Ariba, SAP Concur, SuccessFactor. What is Ariba? It's advanced version of MM. What is SAP Concur? It is advanced version of FI. What is SuccessFactor? It's the advanced version of HR. Okay, now we have got different modules also. So instead of using finance, you can use Success or SAP Concur, some company using. And when you are using MM in the WAST, you can jump on to Ariba also. Okay, for all leading solutions. Now Ariba becoming a big chain point for all the companies. They just want to implement Ariba. Okay, this is the advanced version of inventory, stock, and purchase, everything redefined in Ariba. Okay, we can use this with S4 Concur also with S4 Sector Auto. All the application can be integrated with the core component. What is the core component? Our core component is S4. We can use all technologies with S4 HANA in 17.09. If you heard about HANA releases, they always release called 13.09, 14.05, 16.06, 17.09, 18. What is this 16.06? What is this 17.09? What is this 19.03? What is this 20.09? But the first two letters is the year, is a, like if it is a, where was that? Yeah, 1709 means first two letters denotes the year, and last two letters denotes the month. But in 2017, in the month of September, they release. Whenever you see, you get releases, you can able to see releases like this only. 1709, 1806, 1910. And release never exceeds 12 because we have only 12 months. Okay. And here in 2020 also, they come up with the new things. New things means with the new bundle of features. Okay. With the new scenarios. See, HR is a success factor, is a preceder of HR. Ariba is a preceder of procurement. Concur is a preceder of this finance. And Hybris is a preceder of sales. So nowadays, all if you have S4HANA, you can use all these features in very easily because it's get integrated with the core component called S4HANA, which is said in the middle. You can integrate this SAP core system with different types of LOBs. LOB means line of businesses. This all are line of business only. You can integrate in SAP core system. With the core system, this is my S4 is a core system. You can the modules, the functional modules, you can call it LOB. LOB is line of business. See, this HR, Ariba, Concur, and Hybris. These all are a line of businesses. If any job required, just activate. Otherwise, continue with S4 core system only. You know what happened? In old system also, you can install all these things. But for this purpose, you have to deactivate many business components. Otherwise, you can directly use it with S4HANA without doing all the stress. The first enable of SAP HANA is SAP, because whenever you talk about S4, SAP S4, it's worked on SAP HANA database only. You cannot install any other database with S4. If you think about S4, then you have to go with HANA database only. The user interface, user definitions, SAP Fiori is possible only through HANA database. SAP Fiori is enabled only with HANA database, okay? And as discussed, this is a real-time simplified and real-time architecture. So if you want more scenarios on this, you just see some YouTube videos about S4. This is the glance which I provided you. This is just a glance. Okay, this is the basics. If you know all these names structure in proper way, you can easily tackle an interview if they ask, have you done S4? Have you worked on S4HANA? Because S4HANA is nothing different. The all transition code remains same. Only the database will change. Instead of our third party database, we use the database called SAP HANA database. That is the reason why it's become a S4 HANA on top of HANA database. There is the only one thing which you change from our old traditional way. Okay. So are you getting me on today's session?
Yes, sir, yes.